traveling. My family's used for me being away from home, so it's not like a life-changing deal for me or my family. So, you know, my wife, my kids are all older. It's not like I've got, you know, a 10-year-old and a 12-year-old at home that I got to worry about. So, and on top of that, I didn't have an excuse that I had a job or I was busy. I wasn't doing anything. So, I've learned a lot. I mean, I've learned more than they've learned from me. I've never coached high school or, you know, I like kids that age. You know, I've got three sons. They're all in their 20s now. But, you know, I love kids that age. Number one, they're going to do whatever you tell them or try to do whatever you tell them. So I wasn't really scared or nervous about what was going to happen. I was just nervous on how the game, the protocol for the game, all the little things that happen where you got to come out before the game, you exchange lineup cards. You got to put a player in as soon as the timeout. Twice a night I messed up. I wanted to get a guy in, but in the NBA you wait till the end of the timeout, then you send the guy down there. So two different times a night I didn't get my guy in the game because it was too late. Once the timeout was over, I said, Jason Ray, you're in. They go, no, I can't go in now. So I've made a lot of mistakes like that just because I'm not used to the high school rules. So I'm learning more than the players are probably.
Guys that are ready to play are guys that are ready to play. It doesn't matter if you're 35 years old or 16 years old. You know, they're anxious. They're ready to go. They're chomping at the bit wanting to get out there. I try to be as calm as I can and show a lot of confidence. And, you know, I've been a lot of places and been in a lot of big games. So, you know, I've been through this stuff a lot more than they have. So I'm trying to hope that permeates the locker room. But sometimes it will and sometimes it won't. So it's just a game-by-game thing.